Hello and welcome to episode 33 of Let's Play Final Fantasy XIV, Heavensward. So, in the last episode, you all got to meet Grandmother Matoya here, and she gave us a task. Head over to the Great Google Library. So let's head over there and we also picked up one of these smaller quests, so there we go, that's one out of three. There's the other one, and there's the third one, okay. There we go. What's this? Oh, that can wait. So let's alright, let's see. I hope we can actually do this one with NPCs. Because if I remember correctly, this is one of those dungeons that usually takes longer to find a party than it actually takes to complete it. You stand before the Great Grubel Library, one of Hydaelyn's foremost repositories of knowledge. Alas, it has fallen into disuse since the Exodus some summer since. In all those years, its halls have welcomed not the coming of the single of a single soul. Its floors felt not the loving brush of a broom. Mine apologies, sir. Pray pay no mind to the dreams of the humble broom. You are doubtless eager to venture within and retrieve my lady's tomb. I shall unlock the door at once when you have what you seek. Pray return to the cave and report to my lady. Alright, and that's lucky. We can actually use an NPC party. And apparently one of them is a frog. Interesting. This how like most dungeons in this game looks just awesome. Like this reminds me so much of Kerrigan in World of Warcraft. Like it just looks great.
Focus. Release!
There we go. Come on.
Away with you!
Oh, that was one more. There we go. Thank you. thought that actually was a boss.
I shall make it quick.
There we go. So what did we get? Anything useful? A ring. Vitality, crit, intelligence, indirect hit. I don't think strength, determination, vitality, skill. Alright, so that was the first boss.
Away with you!
There we go, and got this small treasure here. A bucket of dye. Let's go. earrings and the book. Over the horizon. I believe, if I remember correctly, there is actually a book called Over the Horizon. Here comes the next boss.
Have at you!
Away with you! I have my pride!
There we go, and some gloves. They're, well, not useful for me. And I believe We have one more boss.
Focus, release. Away with you!
Yeah!
Away with you!
Yeah! Focus, release! Away with you! Focus, release!
Let's grab the treasure coffer here first, and some more earrings, and leather-bound diary.
Oh. Away with you!
Yeah!
I have my pride. I have my pride.
Yeah.
I have my pride.
There we go. All right. So, I'm not sure, but if we look here now, you can see there is an arrow on this particular dungeon here. And that gave us a cake, which ended up here. And the more we do, the more symbols we get up here. Alright, let's see what's in this chest. Here. Oh, we got a new song and some piece of crap headgear that also looks like a piece of crap. A bow and some leggings for ranged DPS. Or mage DPS, I should call it. And looks like we also got another crystal and to light up. Only got one left now. Then we are at full power again. And there's the book. Magically just appeared in the middle of the room. That's literally full of books. Magic is awesome. What can I say?
So this is the tome. Excellent. Let us take it to Master Matoya at once.
Yep, that sounds like a plan. If I remember correctly, I think there we go. We actually were very lucky there. I did not think about the fact that I was in combat. So if I wouldn't have lost combat in mid-fall, I would actually have died there. Alright, let's talk to Zoro the Frog here. There you go. Yep. I take it you found the tomb. Well, let's see it then. There you go. Hey, this is it, all right. I must say, the experience brought back memories, just like the old days. You still send people into the thick of danger as if it were nothing more than a mundane errand. But we were able to accomplish our task thanks to you, thanks to Pero Rogo. He is an eminently capable familiar. A creation worthy of the great Master Matoya. And to simply witness him in action gave me a better understanding of arcane entities. Should the opportunity present itself, I should very much like to employ this knowledge for the betterment of mankind. Create a new variety of carbuncle, perhaps. Don't get ahead of yourself, boy. Louis's grandson, or no. It'll take another decade under me before you can call yourself a scholar. And a deal more than that to make you a scholar worth a day. Yeah, down into your shoes again, Alphanode. And don't look. As you may have gathered, Master Matoya is not easily impressed. No, she's really not. Indeed. So shall we examine the tomb? And there we go. I think... No, we don't have flying yet. So I guess one more. Uh Dravonian hinterlands. The Shining Mist, the Dravonian forelands. I guess we have two left to do? Actually, yeah. I guess we have two more to do.
I had not thought to behold this tome again. There. It is deciphered. Now your friend should be able to make sense of the contents. That said, it's one thing to understand the workings of the Etheric Converger, and another to actually make it work. You do realize how much ether is required.
Cid is keenly aware of the energy dilemma. His airship is by no means large, and it can only bear a limited quantity of crystals.
If only we had white aurasite in the etheric siphon.
Alas, Minfilia is missing along with both artifacts, and Moonbreeder is gone.
Would that there were another ready wellspring of energy for us to draw upon.
Why did it not occur to us before? We already have what we need, the eye! It has been drawing ether into itself for as long as the Great Worms have lived! It is a veritable wellspring of energy!
It might just suit our needs. But is this energy something that can be harnessed at will?
I believe so, with the aid of the Azure Dragoon of Ishgard.
Then it is settled. Let us return to the Holy See at once.
Stulla, wait. When did the light fade from your eyes?
I might have known that it would not escape your notice. It has been this way since I returned from the life stream. An after effect of the teleportation magic I invoked, most like.
They are called forbidden spells for a reason. What were you thinking, girl?
I have no regrets. I but did what was necessary to preserve the light of hope, to keep my promise to Minfilia. Besides, it afforded me the rare opportunity to wander the ether, a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
I need not tell you that it consumes your very life force to see by sensing the ether around you. Take care of yourself. Do you hear me?
I will, Master Matoya. And thank you.
All right. Oh, wrong one. Damn it. thanks to your customarily heroic efforts, we now possess the knowledge to build an etheric ram. All that remains is to secure its energy source. Let us haste back to Ishgard and consult Sir Emmerich regarding the eye. Alright. I don't see any more. Let's see if there are. No, oh, there is something. But yeah, that can wait. Let's head back to Corpus. All right, and well, we will continue this in the next episode. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode with a short dungeon run and introduction to the Wondrous Tales book, which actually is pretty cool in my opinion. If you did like this episode, then feel free to hit the like button. It helps me a lot, and it also helps other people finding my content on YouTube. If you're new here, first of all, welcome. And if you like my content, feel free to hit the subscribe button together with the notification bell so you don't miss out on any more of my content. I will be back again tomorrow, and until then, stay safe out there.